Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, tip sent in by David from Australia. Now, I think I've shown this on the podcast before, but it's worth repeating because it's a cool little trick. First of all, let's talk about the function called now. Now is an interesting function in that it puts in current date and time. So if you use now, you might be interested in a function called equal today. Today is like now, except it doesn't bother to put in the time. That's nice. As you calculate the spreadsheet, that calculation's not going to change. But what if you want a date and time that isn't going to change, that's just going to be permanent, not the current date and time, but the time that you happen to enter the date in the spreadsheet? Well, hey, a couple of cool tricks here that David sent in. If you just press Control and semicolon, that will put a current timestamp right in the cell. Control and semicolon, and then Ctrl+Shift semicolon, which is basically doing Ctrl:, will give you the current timestamp. Great little trick there. The way to remember it, of course, in time, we have a colon, so it's Ctrl:, to get the time. Just unrelease the shift, Ctrl:, to get the date. Thanks to David for sending that question in. Thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.